On Saturday morning, James Kakoza, 54 years, a resident and LC3 councillor of Kamocha 2B, was murdered while on a road run along Centenary Park. It is alleged that two unidentified men moving on a motorcycle trailed him and hit him with a blunt object on the head and later fled the scene. Addressing the media today during the weekly security briefing, police spokesperson Fred Enanga revealed that one person has been arrested in connection to the gruesome murder. According to the police, the deceased first posted in one of the community social media platforms indicating that he was moving out of his house for his routine exercise. This is believed to have alerted the killers. Netizens have been warned against reckless use of social media, which could cause them trouble.
So it was a pattern that had been mastered by enemies. We are aware of the great role that he was performing in the Kamocha church zone. He's one of those who was working with the community, local councils, to rid the area of criminals and gang crime. But of course, so at this stage, we don't have the clear motivation towards his murder, but we are working on leads that we have already gathered. What we have shows that he was trailed for a very good distance. The footages that we've recovered show us the perpetrators while trailing him. And we so far have one suspect in custody. The others are in hiding, but we have an identity.
Regarding the murder of Batungula Beoti, a UCU student at Makerere University, police say they are following up a list of up to 15 students who are said to be behind the violence that preceded Batungula's brutal murder. Already three people, including Kassanda South MP Frank Kabuye, were arrested and are yet to be arraigned in courts of law. The police are also investigating the students' brigades in the university, which are said to be behind the violent scenes at the university.
We are charging so far the three suspects who were arrested. That is Honorable Kabuye Frank, the MP Kassanda, Sekide Alan, and Kabura Muzaffaru. With incitement to violence, they are expected to appear in court today. As we consolidate the facts surrounding the brutal murder of the victim, further efforts are in place to trace for the perpetrators of violence that are still at large. At least now we have a list of more than 12 to 15 of those external perpetrators of violence. We are also interesting ourselves in the student brigades within the university. One of the brigades is called Northcote Revolutionary Army. That is NRA in bracket. Then there is another brigade called the Ratguard Brigade, RGB.
From the Citizenship and Immigration Department of the Ministry of Internal Affairs, it was revealed that 99% of Ugandans do not own passports, despite it being an official document that every citizen is entitled to. This has been attributed to a number of factors, including ignorance, poverty, among others.
99.87 don't hold passports. 99.97 Ugandans do not hold passports. Now, this is a very worrying trend. With all these numbers we are seeing, those lines you used to see at the Ministry of Internal Affairs, only 0.03 of Ugandans are actually applying and processing passports. I wish to implore Ugandans to come forward and apply for passports, because it is a very, very worrying trend. A passport is a security document, is one of those documents that everyone should have in addition to national ID.
Meanwhile, the head of community policing at police, Anatoly Muletera, has unveiled plans to sensitize masses on land laws and rights. This follows a rise in land-related cases.
As a whole, please, fellow Ugandans, let's move forward on this matter. And please, do not in any way try to move and march the police and say, police, I need you to go and protect me. No. If it is the desire to protect you when you are grabbing land, any individual police officer caught in that action is his own mistake or her own mistake for that matter.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.